Welcome to this .NET PDF library tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to create a table in a PDF document using the Syncfusion .NET PDF library. Then, I will demonstrate how to create tables from various data sources, build nested tables, and insert background images into the table cells. First, I will open an existing ASP.NET Core application where I have already installed the Syncfusion PDF.NET Core package. If you want to know how to get started with the Syncfusion PDF library, check out the video link in the card above or description below. Now, let me proceed to explain the steps to create a simple table in a PDF document using a button click. I will start by opening the index.cshtml file and clearing out the existing code. After that, add a button and assign it to an action method called createTable. To define the action method, I will navigate to the Home Controller class and import the namespaces Syncfusion PDF, Syncfusion PDF Graphics, Syncfusion PDF Grid, and Syncfusion Drawing. Next, I will define the createTable method with the return type actionResult. Within this method, let me create a new PDF document instance and add a page to this document. Then create a PDF grid and add the two columns and add header row to it. Next, I need to access the first header row and set the value of the first cell in the header row to employee ID and the value of the second cell to employee name. To customize the grid style, let me set the custom font to the header, adjust the size to 8, and apply bold formatting. After that, I will add a row to the grid. For this row, I set the first cell to E1 for the employee ID and the second cell to Clay for the employee's name. In a similar way, I add another row with different employee details, E2 as the employee ID and Thomas as the employee's name. Next, I draw the grid on the page. Finally, I create a memory stream and save the document to it. After closing the PDF, let me set the stream position to 0. To enable the PDF download in a browser, I create a file stream result to send the output stream as a PDF document. I set the name of the file that will be presented for download. Then I return the file stream result. Finally, I save and run the application. When I click this button, the PDF is downloaded. I open it, you will see the table containing employee information. Next, let me show you how to create a table from a data source in a PDF document. First, I add another button with the action method, create table from data source. To define the action method, I navigate to the home controller file and add the system data namespace. After that, I define action method, create table from data source with the return type action result. Inside this method, I create a new PDF document instance and add a page. Then I create a PDF grid object and the data table to organize the data. I add a column for ID and another for name. After that, I populate the grid with rows. The first row has E1 for the employee and Clay for the name. Then I add the second row has E2 as the employee ID and Thomas for the employee name. Now I assign the data table as the data source for the PDF grid. Then let me draw the grid on the PDF page at the specified position. I create a memory stream and save the document. Close the PDF and set the stream position as 0. To download the PDF in a browser, I create a file stream result to send the contents of the output stream as a PDF document. I set the name of the file that will be presented for download. Finally, I return the file stream result. I save and run the application. When I click this button, the PDF downloads. See the document, it shows the table created from the data source. Next, I will show you how to create a table using the IEnumerable data source. Add a button with the action method, create table from IEnumerable. Then, navigate to the Home Controller class and define the method with the return type action result. Inside this method, I create a new PDF document instance and add a page to this document. Then I create a PDF grid. Next, create a list for hold the data for the grid. Here, I set the value for the cells in the row. In the same way, I add two more rows with different employee details. Now, let me add each row object to the list. Then, add this list to the IEnumerable. After that, I assign the list to the PDF grid as the data source. Then, I draw the grid on the PDF page, positioning it at specified coordinates. Finally, I create a memory stream to save the document. Close the PDF and set the stream position to 0. To download the PDF, I create a file stream result to send the contents of the output stream as a PDF document. I set the name of the file that will be presented for download. Return the file stream result. I save and run the application. When I click the table from my IEnumerable button, the PDF downloads. I open a file, it's showing the table from the data source. Now let's see how to create a nested table in the PDF. I add a button for create the nested table. Then I define an action method named nested table. Inside this method, I create a new PDF document and add a page to it where content will be drawn. I create a new PDF grid instance and add three columns to it. Then set the width of the third column to 300. I add a new row to the header of the parent grid to define the column headers. Now set the first cell's value to employee ID to this column. In a similar way, set the second cell's value to employee name. Then set the third cell value to contact details for the final column. Next, add a row to the parent grid for the first employee's details. Set the values for the first two cells with a 1 in the first cell and Clay in the second cell. Following this, a child PDF grid is created to represent detailed contact information. The child grid is configured with two columns. And add a new row to the child grid. Here, I will add a new row to the child grid and set the value in the phone column. In a similar way, let me add a new row to the child grid and set the value in the email column. Now let's embed the child grid inside the third cell of the parent grid's header row. Next, let me set padding for the cells within the child grid is set to 5 units on all sides. Finally, draw the entire parent grid on the PDF page. I create a memory stream and save the document to the stream. Then close the PDF document. I set the stream position as 0. To download the PDF document in a browser, I create a file stream result to send the contents of the output stream as a PDF document. I set the name of the file that will be presented for download. Return the file stream result. Finally, I save and run the application. When I click the Create Nested Table button, the PDF is downloaded. I open it, and you can see a created nested table displayed in the PDF document. Finally, I will show you how to add a background image to a table cell. First, I add a button in the index.cshtml and name the action method addBackGroundImageToTableCell. Define an action method with the return type actionResult. I create a new PDF document instance and add a page to the document. Then set up a PDF grid with 3 columns. And add a header row to the grid. Set the first cell to employee ID, the second cell to employee name, and the third cell to salary. Apply a header style with the font set to Helvetica size 8 and bold. Set the first cell to E1, the second cell to clay, and the third cell to $10,000. I create a PDF grid cell style instance. Add an image to the background by creating a new folder named data and placing the image inside it. Create a file stream to retrieve the image stream. Next, I set the background image for the cell using an image stream. Apply the style with the background image to the first cell of the first row in the PDF grid. Set the row height to 50. And set the image to stretch. Draw the grid on the PDF page. I create a memory stream and save the document to the stream. Then close the PDF document. I set the stream position as 0. To download the PDF, I create a file stream result to send the contents of the output stream as a PDF document. I set the name of the file that will be presented for download. Return the file stream result. Finally, I save and run the application. When I click the Add Cell Background button, downloads the PDF, which shows a table with a background image in one of its cells. Let me sum up this video. I've shown you how to create tables from various data sources, build nested tables, and insert background images into table cells in ASP.NET Core using the Syncfusion PDF library in Visual Studio 2022. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our Essential Studio products if you are eligible for our community license. If you found this video useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching.